friends, welcome to Insight Techs. This is a platform to learn about power transmission elements and its control system. So in today's video, we are going to learn about substation equipment wiring of the equipment potential transformer PT. So let's get started. So over here, for example, we have taken a potential transformer with the ratio of 66,000 volts, that is 66 kV by 110 volts. Okay, so assuming this is the primary winding, so the primary winding has one HT terminal and the second end of the primary winding is the neutral. Okay, and to the secondary winding we have two cores over here. Core 1 is for metering core and core 2 is for the protection core. So how the voltage gets divided is we will see, and before that let us see what are the metering core and protection core nomenclature. So 1A 1N represents metering core and 2A 2N represents the protection core. So between this metering core and protection core terminals we have the secondary voltage of 110/√3. Okay, why √3? Because you can see over here the primary winding is connected between a HT, between a phase and neutral. Okay, between a phase and neutral, this neutral is always earth. So the value over here in the primary will always be 66 kV by root 3. So in secondary also you will get 110 by root 3 volts. Okay. There are few precautions that are required. What are they? Let us see. The first precaution is PT secondary never should be short in the charge condition. Okay, so if suppose you are using metering core, you are not using the protection core, then in the PT it should always be kept open. It should never be short circuited. Okay, but when you are using a current transformer, when you are using a CT, it should always be short circuited. So this is the opposite of CT that you have to do in the PT, right? And the second precaution, that is this neutral is always required to be connected to earth. It is always to be connected to earth or grounded in the charge condition for a potential transformer. So these are two very important precautions that are required, okay, while doing the wiring of the potential transformer. Now let us move forward and see how the wiring to the MK box is done in the PT. So now let us see the wiring part. For R phase, Y phase and V phase, as we have discussed, we have this primary winding and secondary winding is having two cores, metering core and protection core. So let us see the wiring in metering core. Okay, so suppose this is our terminal box. So for R phase, from 1A, we will take out R1A, okay, and connect over here. Then R1N will be connected at this point. Similarly, for Y phase, Y1A, Y1N, and B phase, B1A and B1N will be connected over here. Now, from this terminal box, there will be four wires coming out. For R phase, it is called E11. For B phase, it is E31. For Y phase, it is E31. And for B phase, it is E51. You can see that all the three neutrals are connected over here. Okay, they are short circuited and connected to the earth. Now, these four wires are used inside the control panel in the control room, okay, for metering circuit in the panel. So we will use a 4 core 4 square mm cable to carry this four wires. Okay, next important thing is you have to provide fuse over here before you take this four wires to the metering circuit in the control room panel. Okay, and how the divided in this, let us see that. From phase to phase voltage, say from E11 to E31, we will get 110 volt. From E31 to E51, again we will get 110 volts, 110 volts, okay? And if we see from phase to neutral, that is E11 to E71, then we will get RMS value, that is 110 by root 3, that is 63.5 volts between phase to neutral or phase to earth, okay? So similarly, you will get for Y phase and B phase, that is E31, E71, you will get 63.5 volts, and E51 to E71 also, you will get 63.5 volts. Now let us see the wiring for the protection core for RY and B phase. Now we will be using 2A, 2N terminals. Okay, so for R phase, you have R2A and R2N connected. For Y phase, you will have Y2A and Y2N connected. For B phase, you will have B2A and B2N connected in the manner shown over here. Again, from this, we will have 4 wires coming out, 3 for each phase, E21, E41 and E61, and the remaining 3 neutrals will be connected to each other and will be short circuited and connected to earth. Again, we will use a protection, we'll use this 4 cables for protection circuit inside the control room panel, and to do that we will require a 4-core 4-sporanum cable. We will use fuse before we provide this wires into the protection circuit in the control panel. Again, the voltage is divided similarly between E21 and E41, E41, E61 and E61, E21, that is phase to phase voltage we will get is 110 volts, but phase to earth voltage will be 63.5 volts. Shown over here is the actual PTMK box inside the switchyard. So you can see that in this terminal box the wiring is done and the fuses are provided. Taking a closer look, you can see this gray wires. These wires are coming from the PT inside the terminal box. Okay, over here we have connected into the RY and B terminals for metering and protection. Okay, 3 for metering and 3 for protection. Okay, and through this fuse, using this fuse, these wires are coming over here, and from here, using this cable, we are providing these wires to the control panel now. Okay, so in the next video, we will see how these wires, we have to do how the wiring for this cable inside the control panel. So that's it for today's video, guys. In the next video, we will continue the wiring from MK box to the control panel. Keep watching videos. Thank you.